Friday Night Flights, Travis Bundy, James Stowe, in the house.
I gotta have some more of that.
Tonight we are at...
That is super duper good.
We are at... Let's see if that'll show up. I don't know that one. Otter?
Yeah, you can kind of see that.
Who has an amazing logo, and signage, and
I'll
beer.
Those
are pretzels. See? Pretzels. So this is... So what we just pulled drank, that's the Son of Otter.
It's their Belgian.
It's their Belgian. And it is 8%.
It's 8.
I don't have a IBUs on this.
Screeching Otter is 9.2.
Well, shit, man.
And the Comrade's 11. Shit, I want to drink that.
No, you don't.
I know I don't, but I want to drink 11.
Yeah, they got three that are, they don't do in flight. But all of their ones on their list, which I think they had, what, 7 tonight? So basically, you can basically get 8, or you can get almost all of the entire list on one flight, which is 6. So, pretty good deal. I think they vary because they have different prices for the different gravities.
Yeah, I think between these two.
Mine was like 13 and yours was what?
12.
12. So. Okay, so, I mean, look at the color on the chart. It's so good. Look at that. It's a Belgian. It's got citrus radiance, lemon zestiness, which I can definitely taste.
Holy Otter awesomeness. I don't know what that means.
But I like it.
I do. It's really good.
Yeah.
I would drink this every day.
Yeah, it's really easy to drink.
Yep, easy.
But it's complex and interesting.
Yeah.
I really like it. I like it. Yeah, it's cool.
How about the, did you get the Luck of the Irish?
I did, Luck of the Otter.
Luck of the Otter, right, Luck of the Otter.
Okay, Luck of the Otter, the Irish Stout.
I'm going to hate this.
He's going to hate it.
It's going to be gross.
Yeah.
So, let's preface this. Let's do this. Like, we did this last time.
Right.
I'll do it again. You guys know my preferences. I like dark beers. I like really hoppy IPAs. And I like lagers, so I'm kind of all over the place.
Sure.
As far as, like, style, but this motherfucker likes... How would you like?
I like lagers. Lagers are great. I have a wide range. I just don't like dark beers. I don't like porters and stouts generally. I love sours, and the hoppier the IPA, the better.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. But generally, I don't enjoy stouts or, in a black and tan. Pretty much the only way I can take them.
Really? Yeah. They have to be cut by something?
That's right. That's right. That's right. Absolutely. Oh, this is going to be the worst.
Let's watch his face.
Wait, is that, yeah, this is right here. Wow, that's good. That's pretty good.
Oh, we have a convert.
No, the aftertaste is terrible.
Oh, that's nice. Yeah, it's real bready. And it's got like a real like coffee. It's real coffee forward.
Yeah,
so it's
real
it's not like... It's
the back end though is way too...
It's definitely got a bitterness to it that I'm sure a lot of people might be a little put off by, but... That was dry. That Irish. Would you say it had salt?
Sure, there's salt there.
Now, it is a bit bitter for a stout. Like, when you think of stout...
Which is all right. I'm okay with
stout,
that.
You think of, like, a creamy, kind of like...
Yeah, it is not
You know,
bad.
We're going based on, like, the generic origins of stout.
Everything is either upfront or after.
Yeah, it's really quick and fast.
Yes.
Like, it doesn't linger at all.
Absolutely.
Or it doesn't,
well,
like,
no,
it
that's
doesn't,
not true. It lingers a little too much.
It doesn't...
But the mint is what's lingering for me. I don't know about you.
What? That's not...
I know. I just want to make sure that you're drinking
you
the same thing
cleanser in it.
Actually, yours tastes radically different than mine.
I think you picked up the wrong beer.
No, I... Sure. Oh, wait a minute. I did. What am I drinking?
You're drinking the Otter tea.
Oh, well, crap. That's why.
You gotta drink that one.
I do. I gotta drink that. I'm sorry. I screwed this all up. I drank the wrong one. And we just started drinking. It's gonna make me so
Friday
upset.
Friday night. It's gonna happen. I'm just gonna make a bark.
Yeah, that's terrible. That is no good. I mean, this was alright. Oh, wow. It's like drinking an ashtray. Yeah.
Yeah, it's really, you see what I'm saying?
Like, absolutely.
It's very blunt.
Yeah, you and I were, I'm glad I tried yours. Because you and I were drinking two completely different things. I'm like, oh yeah, there's lots of hints of stuff with this. And you're like, no, I don't think so. This is the kind of beer where, you know, somebody says, this beer will put a hair on your chest, it'll make you a man. This is that kind of beer.
It'll put a little hair on your schmeckle.
Unfortunately.
Look how dark that shit is. You can't even see through it.
You can't. Mm-mm. It's not good.
It's awesome.
No.
Nope, it's not good. It's amazing. I like that.
I'm probably going to drink yours. Pretzel, save me. No. Hell no, you're not going to drink mine.
Well, let's cleanse the palate.
I wish I could. Up. I still have half of it to drink.
Well, you just... How do you just take it like a man at the end?
No, I'm going to drink it now. I got to go in order. Right?
Well, you work up the courage to finish that beer.
No, I don't need courage. I'm just going to drink it. Oh, Jesus Christ.
No, okay. Do me a favor and speak with an Irish accent for the moment.
I cannot do that. No. Don't get a lot of Irish accent.
Well, I think it's mostly the music.
I would go Scottish, maybe.
Yeah, but it's not sweet enough.
No, but it's
like smoky and creamy. Sure. It's more just kind of.
I don't get the coffee at all. Maybe
really?
I'm not. Maybe it's because I'm just like.
It's like straight up coffee grounds.
You know what? Now that you say coffee grounds, I'm like, oh yeah, that's what I'm tasting.
It's the bitterness.
Yeah, that's what I'm tasting. Yeah. Is the coffee grounds. That I immediately went, oh, but no, it's coffee grounds.
Granted, I couldn't drink like this all day. I could probably have all pints.
No, that would be a punishment.
I could probably have 8 pints.
That being said, it's not a badly crafted beer.
Right.
It's just not to my taste.
Yeah, it's complex.
To say that it was a bad beer would be an insult, because it's not. It's
right.
A great beer.
Yeah.
It's just not to my taste.
You didn't.
The Otter Quetzal. The Otter Quetzal is...
I don't have, but...
Right. It's a pale ale. 5.1%. Peruvian purple corn. Okay.
Or as they call it, maize.
Perhaps. Mosaic hops. Citra hops. Light, summery, grapefruit, that's what I was trying to say, grapefruit. With the color of it, I would not immediately assume that it's like a grapefruit. No, I would assume
grapefruit's
a pale, right, I would assume a pale is a pale. But this is not. This is very dark, which makes me think they screwed my order up. So I'm going to try it. There's a lot of hop in there. That's really, really good.
Yeah?
Yeah, you should try that. Yeah. I like
that.
I would drink that all the time. Absolutely all the time.
Oh, I instantly regret not getting this.
Yeah. No, that is super amazing.
It's
amazing. Yeah.
Yeah, it's like, it's hoppy, but it's also fruity.
Yeah.
But not like fruit loops.
It's not
where
bitter.
It's like where they're really trying to cram that
right.
Fruit down.
No.
You could drink it all day.
I could drink that all day. And at 5.1, I would drink it all day.
Yeah, you definitely could. Take you like 12 of those to get fucked
up. As a matter of fact, when I ordered it, I'm like, oh, a grapefruit pale ale. I was thinking something along the lines of a shandy.
Sure.
Which is not what I got at all.
Yeah.
But I'm pleasantly surprised.
Yeah,
right, what do you got? What's the thing you got that's next? The Otter Melon, which I have.
So I'm going to skip ahead to the Mama's Pancake.
Yeah, enjoy that all by yourself. That is terrible.
That is the Mama's Pancake Porter, 8%. Traditional porter, maple, breakfast. Mama's love if she loved you enough to give you extra beer for breakfast. Unfortunately, mine does. So this is
my mother would never give me beer for breakfast.
And your mother really doesn't love you.
Well, if she gave me that, though, I wouldn't eat it. It's 8%.
Oh,
I would not. I'm going to enjoy this delicious drink while we're drinking that.
See, porters for me are really hit and miss, because sometimes I'll get a porter and it will, I'll have this idea in my mind of porter. It's full body, it's almost like a stout, but it's just got kind of like a different level of ingredients. It's not as smoky or dark.
Sure.
It's just more of like a lower end stout, but I still want it sweet and I still want it to be not thick, but definitely not watery. The fact that it says pancake, you really get that in
you
the
want it. Yeah, you want it to win. Really? You get the maple?
The maple, it hits it. The maple's all over my lips right now.
All right,
that probably sounded really bad.
Try it. I'm worried about it.
It's actually sweet. It's good. Taste it to the palate.
Yeah, that's sweet.
Right?
Holy crap.
Right? It's the maple. It's got to be the maple.
It is the maple. Yeah. I would drink it.
Yeah, it's not super
I
dark.
Wish I actually I had ordered
it's actually
that
kinda orange-ish.
Instead of the luck of the otter, which I had choked down, that I would have not enjoyed, but I would have drank it.
Yeah.
Cheers to our drinks that are not the same.
We're toasting diversity.
Sure. Use the big words.
Alright. Let me drink the rest of this bit. So we can move on. These are our lists.
Right. We are not beer experts. We just enjoy beer.
We're just alcoholics.
I think calling it a pale ale with grapefruit splendor is
diminished
kind of, a little bit. Yeah. I mean, it's hop forward.
Yeah.
It's not like a strong, dry your mouth out like a desert IPA. But there's solid hop flavor there. My mouth is full of hop. But it was a smooth drink, and I enjoyed it a lot.
Right.
I don't know where the Peruvian purple corn comes in, but it lets them call it Quetzal. So for that reason alone, it's good.
They can put a snake on it.
Right.
With feathers.
So what's although I don't know who did their logo.
I love their logo.
But their logo is awesome.
It's really cool.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right, let's jump to the Otter Melon.
That is the Hef.
Yes,
let's do that. I love Hefeweizen.
Yeah?
A good Hefeweizen is a gift from God. But it's so easy to screw up a Hefeweizen.
Tell me about it.
I can count the number of Hefeweizen that are really good on like two fingers. Try this one.
This is the Otter Melon.
The Otter Melon.
It's got a fresh watermelon extract in it too. So add a little something else.
All right, here we go. Wow, that's way sweet.
Yeah, it's really sweet.
That's a lot of watermelon extract.
It hits you like a Jolly Rancher.
It really does.
Oh, and the end is like a spree.
Yeah.
No. It's not a spree. It tastes like,
it is candy flavored.
Like, ooh, Flintstones vitamins. That's what it tastes like. It tastes like Flintstones vitamins.
Yeah, no. And so if you enjoy your Flintstones vitamins and alcohol, this is a fine
drink.
And
who doesn't?
I am really weirded out by this drink.
It's making me question my life and God.
No, it makes me feel
everything.
Like I'm mixing two things that shouldn't be mixed together.
Like,
my beer.
Like somebody poured NyQuil in this or something?
My beer and my candy. I'm not even overemphasizing the candy taste.
It's like drinking candy. I'm gonna drink this quick because it's kind of creeping on me now.
That is not at all what I was expecting. But they do call it Otter Melon.
Right. They're not fucking around by telling you that it's anything else.
Summer plus fresh watermelon extract. Yes, a lot of it. Plus awesome, bright, and vibrant Hefeweizen. I don't taste that.
No, it's The Hefeweizen was overshadowed heavily by the fact that it's
like a base liquid for 400 ml extract. But that being said, it's 5% watermelon extract, which, you know, can't complain about.
Yeah, and it's actually tasty and it's interesting.
Yeah. Although, if I ordered a Hefeweizen, just ordered a Hefeweizen, wanted to drink a Hefeweizen.
Yeah, then you'd be disappointed.
I would, in fact, be disappointed. Uh-huh. I'm a little disappointed now. Especially with our lead-in of, oh, Hefeweizen, we really enjoy that.
Yeah, yeah.
I was expecting a bad Hefeweizen, and I didn't get a bad Hefeweizen.
No, it's just weird.
I got a watermelon beverage.
Yeah.
That I wouldn't even call a beer.
Well, you know what, though? I mean, this, I will say, though, this beats that, what's that, 51st Amendment has that watermelon beer?
Oh, yeah, no, that is
Heller High watermelon.
Oh, that is... God, off to not trust it.
Drink this. Yeah, drink this instead.
Oh my God,
it is so sweet.
It's like this. It is crazy sweet. I would love to talk to the brewer about what he was thinking with this beer and whether he thinks it is a successful beer.
I'm pretty sure he feels it's a success or they wouldn't have put it out, but...
Oh, I don't know.
What level of success is what I'm saying.
Would you say it's good?
I would say it's palatable.
I would also say it's palatable.
Good would entail that I would actually drink it again.
I would not
get
drink
a pint
it.
Of it, and I probably wouldn't.
I would not do that either.
If you're into like really super sweet beers, give it a shot. You could probably drink it. You could probably handle a pint of it.
If you do not like beer, this is the beer for you.
That's his tagline.
That's right.
Okay, that's it. We're going to go talk to the brewer afterwards and give him that for his tagline.
It's weird that I'm now going to, what am I, the Oddity. I've already done half of it, thinking it was another beer. I wonder now, I'm really upset that, this is a brown ale. I'm really upset that I made so many faces at the brown ale, thinking it was a stout. I'm wondering if my hate for stouts has colored my, I'm really upset if I'm a snob against stouts. So if I now try this knowing it's a brown ale, will I enjoy it? Because I think if you rewind, I didn't like it. And I thought it was minty. Yeah, I'm really, now they said this is a porter replacement on their list. So, and look at it. I mean, it is not a brown ale. Unless you consider it to be the blackest of brown ales.
When you smell
it. Yeah, no, the aroma is amazing.
You get those real Indian spices like right off of it.
All right, try it.
Yeah, I love it. You get the coconut right off the bat, though. Yeah,
it was funny because I was immediately trying to go, oh, coffee malt, chocolate malt, St. Patrick's, because I thought it was a different beer. But now that I know it is what it is, it's got a strong coconut beginning. It's got the chai aftertaste, which I thought was mint. I still don't like it, though.
While it is technically a brown, it does kind of transcend into that like colder stout brown, just because there's so much going on in it. And while there's coconut and there's chai, and there's kind of a neat amalgam of like interesting flavors in there, it's still a very dark beer.
I gotta breathe it out. I mean, there's some strong aftertaste there.
Yeah, but the coconut is so forward.
Yeah.
That makes me
it drops off almost completely.
It does, but then but when it drops off,
it
just feeds right into that chai flavor.
Yes.
So if you did chai, even if you're not like a dark beer fan,
you know, I
would say if you like chai, or if you drink coffee, I guess, give it a shot.
I don't know. It's
actually really good.
And
interesting,
it is 5.9.
That's pretty good for a dark beer like this. Usually this would be like around 7 or 8, isn't it?
I feel bad. I feel bad that I judge this. Although I can't honestly say that I like
the mint thing. I don't think you're actually tasting mint. I think what it is the chai flavor is a little spicy, and it kind of opens up your tongue a bit, the same way mint does.
Sure.
So you're getting that feeling of mint without the flavor.
No, I would agree. But now that I know it, it's a brown ale, the darkest brown ale I've ever seen in my life. That being said, I would not order it.
Well, no, but it's also not in your palate, so.
But again, the same thing with the stout. I can't say that it's a badly made beer.
No, it's fantastically made.
I would say the only thing that I don't think is well made is the Hefeweizen, because it tastes and feels like a mistake. You're just. It feels like,
I think they were going for candy beer. I'm going to put it on the line and say they were going for straight up candy beer.
That's why I want to talk to the brewer. I would like to talk to the brewer and actually ask him, hey, what was your thinking here? Yeah, no, they have a padlock on it and everything. There's no way we're getting in there. Well, we're on our last beer.
We're going to go get more.
We are. They call them the Blind Otters. It's the same beer, except it's stored in a different barrel. So port barrel, like bourbon barrel, and what's the third barrel? Cognac barrel. And I want to try each of them.
Those
sound, all three of them. And I want to try the difference of the three of them. So we're definitely not doing that. I'm just surprised we've gotten through this flight.
Because we're not bullshitting.
I think we're bullshitting quite a bit. I think if you ask the people around us, they'd be like, what the fuck are these people talking about? Why are they debating their beer so much?
And why are they talking so loudly into an iPad?
Also true. Also, yeah. So I'm drinking the Screeching Otter Imperial IPA. It's 9.2.
It looks amazing.
That's a double thumbs up for me, 9.2. It is a 7-hop variety, mild, malty, dry hop West Coast Imperial IPA. There is not a word in that description I do not like.
I am having the Comrade.
So sad that you have to finish with a terrible, terrible.
I find your hatred of dark beers disturbing.
Drinking another stout, a Russian Imperial Stout.
11.7%.
Which, hey, that is. Yeah. Cocoa. Ugh.
So it's Ecuadorian chocolate. Chocolate, which, as we all
Nothing
know,
it says Russian Imperial Stout like Ecuadorian chocolate.
Hey.
Delicious, rich bodies, a mighty intense beer experience.
Well, 11.7%.
So, you're going to let me try that terrible thing, and I'm going to let you try this delicious thing, right?
Yeah, right. Yeah, okay. That's how we're going to do it.
Here we go. So this is the Screeching Otter, and that is the Comrade Otter.
Yes.
Here we go. Cheers.
Cool. Oh, you're going to fucking hate this.
Oh. This is a superb beer. That is totally what I want from an Imperial IPA.
Oh, yeah?
Holy crap, that is good.
Has it got a punch?
No punch. No front end assault at all.
Really?
It's all back end hop.
We all like know how much breathe. We like back end hop.
You know, hey.
Yeah!
When you can breathe a cloud of what you assume is like dragon fire hop, it is good. And
that's a bold statement.
I can still do it. I can still feel the hop taste on my tongue as I exhale. Oh yeah,
it's pretty good.
It's a beautiful, beautiful color.
Yeah.
Here, you try that.
Okay.
You cannot say that.
You are gonna fucking hate that.
I am gonna fucking hate
that. Oh my god!
Yeah,
are you shitting me?
That is super good.
Are you fucking shitting me? I might get a pint of this beer. This isn't what you normally expect from a double IPA. Normally a double IPA is just like, it almost seems like overkill sometimes.
Yeah. Oh, absolutely.
Like, it's like super, like,
and I think people do that
tarp, recoil, and horror.
High IPA, you expect to be beat.
But it's actually quite sweet.
Yeah.
For a double IPA, it's actually really fucking sweet.
Yeah, they really played with the malt.
Yeah.
Yeah. Say, of all the beers I've tried, this one shows the most depthness of the brew.
Huh?
Is that a word?
Sure, depthness? Yeah, it's a word.
Oh, I think you said, depth.
No, not depth, that depth. And
he's smarter than me.
This could have been in the front, which is not a bad thing. An IPA. It's artisanal.
There you go. This is actually more of a finesse move, but you could have easily made this into like a straight up roundhouse.
Yeah. This beer makes me want to hold it in my mouth for a little bit before I swallow it. And you shouldn't want to do that with an IPA, but here it's so malty and smooth that it's okay. Otherwise, you're like, oh God, it's going to burn the layer of my tongue off.
Sure.
I don't want that.
Yeah.
This is possibly one of my new favorite IPAs. Like, for Imperial IPAs, this is incredibly well done. I would give the brewer a high five right away. Boom. This is amazing. I'm glad I ended with it.
Brewer,
even though it was number one on my list. Completely destroyed this terrible stoutness that I put in there just a second ago. It's gone.
Don't listen to it.
Okay,
so this is actually a really well-made stout. I mean, look how dark it is. It's got a nice head on it. It's been that way since it was poured, even after we drank out of it. It's nothing special though, but it is an Imperial Stout, and I'm sure, but then again, it's 11%. Did you taste 11%?
I did not, no.
Right. So that in and of itself is a total ton.
My body did try to reject it though, in a gag.
That's you.
Yes.
That's just you. That's not me. I was like, give me more.
No. There's almost no aroma to see there.
No,
so it's really.
It's very misleading. It's very misleading if you smell it. It doesn't seem like it's like really high alcohol.
Yeah,
this one, you can really taste the cocoa and you can really taste the chocolate. The chocolate is really like coats your tongue afterwards. And that's kind of the mark of like a standard like stout, chocolate stout, is if it coats your tongue afterwards. If it's kind of like a loose stout, kind of like a Guinness or something like that, it's just gonna wash back. You're not gonna taste any afterwards. I'm still tasting this on the back of my tongue. I
should have more of this. Because it would remove it completely.
There's a bit of a spike in the beginning, but that's probably because of the high alcohol content. And it's a fucking Russian Imperial Stout. They're always like that. You have Rasputin, you have any of those Russian Imperial Stouts.
Yeah, it's almost 12%.
Punchy.
I mean, it literally almost 12%.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But you know what? It doesn't taste like 12%.
Nope.
I've had 12% beers. I've had 13% beers, like the Beer Zerker and all these other ones that are like, you literally taste like you're drinking alcohol.
You know, these are fantastic.
Yes. You've had like really super, super fucking heavy, high alcohol content beers that they let you know their high alcohol content right off the bat.
Yeah.
This doesn't, which is already amazing. So, in a way, this isn't a beer I could drink all day because after about three, I'd probably be on my ass.
Yeah, but, 12%. You'd be on your ass.
Yeah, but I wouldn't know it. This is the true definition of something that I like to call shinobi beer, where it sneaks up on you and then straight up.
Nice. Well, you know what? Let's cheers to this fantastic place. This is probably the best six beers I've tried.
Yeah.
Like, and I've never been here, so.
Let's look at those other beers, because they look awesome.
Yes, let's do that. Oh my God, that was good.
So this is the
Blind Otter.
Three Blind Otter series.
Except we didn't go with three because I don't think either of us like pork.
No.
No.
So you know, so this amount of beer, which is the same amount as this.
Yeah.
This is $10.
That is $10.
This is
and
so
it is
15%.
So this is the cognac barrel,
mm-hmm.
And that is the bourbon barrel. And I've already smelled this. This aroma is worth at least half of the cost of the beer. You can smell it. Is that
is fantastic.
My God.
Yeah. Oh yeah, that's good too. Cheers to this. It's gonna be a fantastic experience. That's almost not beer.
It's almost bourbon. It's a, like a watered down bourbon.
That is the smoothest. By far.
Yeah, for sure.
The caramel
notes here are just...
This thing is
absolutely
coating,
amazing.
Not just it's coating my lips, but it's coating my entire throat and my stomach.
Here, let's try it.
Yeah, definitely.
Because you need to try this.
Yeah,
I would imagine this is just a less sweet version of this.
But this is more smoky and probably more...
No, this is just like syrup.
Yeah. See, these are basically like the same beer, right?
Yeah.
Except this one gives you kind of like a spike, an upward spike, kind of dark cherry, like a raspberry, Chambord kind of flavor. Whereas this is like kind of a downward, peaty, dark, dank.
Still sweet. Don't get us wrong.
Super sweet. Super sweet.
It's syrupy, but not in an artificial way.
These are a pleasure. These really are, and I'm gonna nurse this thing for like 20
Me too.
Minutes.
Like, this is not something that should be right. This is worth $10.
Oh yeah.
For 5 ounces.
Oh, easy.
Which is hard to say. Like, no one wants
this
to say
this
that.
Is something you come in here, you get one of these, and you drink it for like an hour.
Yep. This is fantastic.
But no, this is something that you actually would sit. It's too sweet to drink really fast.
No, you would not want to chug this.
There is a reason, I think legally binding reason, they only give you this much.
Right.
Because this is all you need. This will
I would agree. I would come here literally every day to get this.
Mm-hmm.
Just right after work, one of these will set you right.
Yep. Go home, you can deal with the kids.
Oh, I'm so glad we ordered this. Here, you know, this deserves a second cheers.
Prost. In summation, Otter makes some amazing fucking beer.
Absolutely.
I mean, they're
and in a way that you know they know what they're doing.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. This
except,
is not just... Oh,
except apparently for the watermelon, which was a total shot in the dark.
Was it though? That's why I want to know.
I
need to ask questions.
They need to make something for 21-year-olds.
Are you saying it's a rave beer?
It's rave.
Yeah, because beer is not really the drink of raves.
Not at all. Dude, this is joy.
This is joy.
This is drinking pure joy.
Absolutely.
God damn it. This is right up my alley here. I'm a huge whiskey and bourbon fan.
Me too. Oh, we should do it. We should do a whiskey tasting night.
Actually, there's a place in Spokane. Okay, so here's the deal. Spokane Comic Con. You need to come with me. All
right.
There's a place that does whiskey flights.
Oh, God, yes. We need to do that.
Friday night flights.
Whiskey flights.
Yeah, we'll do that.
I want to go back for this. I want to take little sips of it for like an hour. Yeah, this is not a beer I just want to take big gulps of. This is a beer I want to savor over a long
time. I'm actually very sad that I've already made it this far.
I would agree.
I
would say this is masterful. Yeah. I don't know who the brewer here is, but I'd like to shake his hand because this is a fantastic beer.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
He definitely gets a high five for this.
Absolutely.
He gets a big old Arnold Schwarzenegger, Carl Weathers Dylan handshake for his high five.
In Tacoma, Washington, there is one place to go. Actually, there's like five places to go. But the first place you need to go is Otter Brewing Company. And if they still have it, ask for the three blinds. It will cost you a lot of money. Well, wait.
$10? Who can't afford $10? If you're going out and drinking beer, and you're actually an enthusiast, it's a really small price to pay for something so amazing. I mean, like...
Oops. I think my coach is here. Hello.
That might be the end of Friday Night Flights.
Thank you very much. This was fantastic. I hate to do this. It's a wonderful beer, but...
He's an animal.
I'm also not going to leave it for anybody.
All right. Like and subscribe. Friday Night Flights!